Good morning, you two, and welcome to our first online art lesson. It's going to be a little bit different, and it's going to be a learning experience for all of us, including me, definitely including me. I've never done anything like this before. So let's all work together and try and do our best, because it's a new experience for everybody. Mums and dads, nannies, children, and teachers too. So for our next unit in art, we are going to be learning about how we can use old unwanted things, household materials, natural materials from the garden to make art. Because I'm not expecting anybody at the moment to go out or any mums and dads to go out and buy materials. We're going to be really creative, we're going to problem solve, and we're going to make art materials and art from things that we can find around the house. Okay, so it's going to be a big challenge. Our learning question for today is, can I create my own art materials? So your challenge, boys and girls, is to make your own paintbrush and your own paint. Okay, sounds like a good challenge. I know some of you will have lots of paintbrushes and paint, some of you will have none, but your challenge for today, your art lesson, is to create your own paintbrush and your own paint, and I'm going to help you with that. So I've got examples here of some of the things we're going to do. Okay, so I hope everybody's on board. Let's give it a try. Okay, year two. So your challenge is to create your own paintbrush using materials that you find in the home, okay, and also perhaps in your garden or outside, okay? So first of all, you are going to need something to be the handle of the brush, okay? So I found lots of things around my home. I found clothes pegs, I found chopsticks, cotton buds or Q-tips, even a Kirby grip or a bobby pin. You could maybe use an old pen or pencil. Get creative, boys and girls. Get your nannies or parents or whoever's looking after you involved to help. And please ask permission before you take anything. Once you have found something to be your handle, you're gonna need something to be the brush part. So here are all the brushes that I have made. I really like this one with natural kind of materials. This was a chopstick, some leaf or foliage, and I tied it on with yarn or wool, okay? This is quite tricky to do the tying, so you could get somebody to help you, or you could secure it with Sellotape first. I've also made, this one was really easy, using an old pencil and some paper or card that I cut up into thin pieces. Even if you think you have no card in your house, I bet you have some old boxes in the kitchen, maybe an old cereal box, you could borrow the box from it. Maybe you've got newspapers, old leaflets, magazines. Have a good look. Ask people to help you, ask other people in your house to help you. This one was made with yarn. I tied it into a big knot and I just sellotaped it onto the end of this. This is a kind of skewer for kebabs from the kitchen. I love this one as well, made using natural materials, a stick and leaves and masking tape. Tin foil is a really good way to create your handle. And I've simply poked lots of, what do we call these? Pipe cleaners. Pipe cleaners are great as well. You could use them if you've got any from a craft box in your house. You can use them for the handle or for the brush part. Clothes pegs are excellent because they do a lot of the work for you. You can just trap something in to the end. You could maybe do the same thing with this technique, and they make it really easy because they will just hold it. So I put a little bit of foam from the kitchen in here. Okay, boys and girls, that is your first part of the challenge. Good luck, get creative. You may have paintbrushes at home, but our challenge is to create your own. Good luck, everyone. Okay, for the next half of our art lesson, you are going to attempt to create your own paint or ink. So I have got a great way to recycle old materials and to create new materials to use. I've soaked these overnight, some old markers in a little bit of water. And this allows all the ink to come out of the markers. Even if they seem all dried up, they will still release ink into the water, and you can make your own watercolour inks. Isn't that a fantastic idea? Now, if you've got old markers in the house, is a great option to use them up and recycle them. If you do not have any old ones, perhaps you could donate one marker and just use a tiny bit of water, a small amount of water, to let the ink soak out into it. Okay, so that is one way that you could create your own paint. Another option I have is using coffee. Now, for these, you must ask somebody's permission, and I'd probably ask them to help as well. I have soaked some coffee into some hot water and then let it cool, and you can create your own, I don't know if the camera will catch it, you can create your own brown ink. All right, I have got some chili powder here. You get lots of spices and chilies with really good pigment, really good colors in them. And if you soak that, hot water seems to be best, you can also create your own inks. Now, I'm gonna share with you some other ideas if you want to get creative. Try your best, boys and girls. I do want you, if possible, have a try. Ask mums and dads or whoever's around in the house if they can help you, if they can help you to think creatively and find your own materials. Another option I had, another thing I thought of, was food colouring. Perhaps you could use food colouring for your paints. My tip, boys and girls, would be to just use a small amount of water, okay? If you use too much water, it's going to be too diluted and watery and you're not going to get a good rich pigment for your paints. Okay, you're going to be little scientists as well as artists today. Good luck, everybody. Now to test it out. Let's try a little bit of our red first. Wow, now it's a little bit harder to control these brushes than our normal brush, but that's okay. It will give us a nice effect. We can even do some dripping. Okay, year twos, thank you for joining me for our first ever online art lesson. It was a little bit nerve-wracking. I don't know if you were nervous too, but I was. I can't wait to see all your uploads. So boys and girls, our learning intention was, can I create my own art materials? Our success criteria points, the three things I want you to achieve, are I can use materials found in my home or garden, I can use my homemade materials to create art, okay? You may not be happy with the artwork, but give it a try, okay? And I can reflect on the process, okay? So maybe it will work, maybe it won't work. Your job is to reflect on that, okay? And later on in the week, I'm gonna send you out some little questions to answer as a reflection, okay? Boys and girls, today is Monday and you've got 1 week to upload your artwork, okay? But as soon as you get it finished, upload it, because later on in the week before next Monday, I'm gonna hopefully share some people's ideas, share some people's feedback, and help to share tips with our whole year two group, okay? Take a photo of the paintbrush before you start painting, because it may get a little bit damaged or destroyed when you start to paint with it. But it's all a learning experience, boys and girls. Good luck!